السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. رب زدني علما. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. I welcome you all to this class of العربية، دروس اللغات العربية لغير الناطقين بها. نعم. We've been doing the last lesson. In the last lesson, we've been doing the lesson number 4. Right? We've been doing the lesson number 4. And we learned an important rule. It's not, that any word which comes after a preposition, any word which comes after a preposition, such as fi, which means in, and ala, which means on, min, which means from, ila, to, right? Any words which comes after it becomes majroor. We learned about the three cases in Arabic language. We learned about the three cases in Arabic language, and those are marfu', mansub, and majroor. What's marfu'? Marfu' is any word which has a dhamma at the end. Dhamma at the end, which has a pesh at the end, it has a dhamma at the end, right? Talibu. And marfu is the default state of any word. Marfu is the default state of any word, right? It's called marfu. And any word which has a kasra, minal madrasati, this is called majroor, genitive case. Yeah, marfu is nominative case. This is marfu, which is nominative, and genitive case, which is madrasati. So because of this min or fi or ala or ila, and there are almost 16 or 17 prepositions, they cause the word after it to become a genitive word. Yeah, a kasra, majroor. And there's another case which is called mansub, which is a fatha. Fatha. Yeah, inshallah. We'll learn about the mansub case in the future, inshallah ta'ala. That is what we learned in the last lesson, lesson number 4. Lesson number 4, this is what we've been focusing on. When we come to lesson number 5, it is very important because this creates a new dimension in Arabic language. It creates a new perception in Arabic language where we learn about mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. Because in Arabic, in English, we have we use of to show possession of things, yeah? House of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or an apostrophe S, Allah's house. Similarly, we have two constructions, two words coming together to form a special construction, which is called mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. Mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. It is very important, and for some students, they find it very difficult in the beginning to get a good grasp of mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. Mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, they find it very difficult to get a good grasp of this, inshallah. But we will try our best to understand, inshallah. But remember that it will take time to get a good grasp of this. But once you get a good grasp, mudaf and mudaf ilayhi is filled in the Quran. It's filled in the Quran. Yeah? Because every page, almost every page, or every two pages has mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. Because someone or something has possession, his book, his Lord, yes? Be it through a pronoun, be it through a proper noun, anything, it is filled with possession. Possession. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Malikul Mulk. Yeah? So he's the Malik, the owner of everything, the kingdom. Malikul Mulki. Right? So this special construction is called Mudaf and Mudaf Ilayhi. Mudaf and Mudaf Ilayhi. Right? Let's look at some notes before we continue. Mudaf or mudaf ilayhi. We've done this before in the last lesson of mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. And inshallah, we will someone's getting an error. Okay. Okay. مضاف and مضاف إليه. So this is used, what is mudaf? The first word is called the mudaf, which is the possessed, the one thing which is owned by someone, the thing, the article, the person or whatever, whatever which is owned. For example, Abdullah, the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Abd is itself a mudafun. It's called possessed. And mudaf ilayhi is the possessor. 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 The owner is called mudafun ilayhi. Okay, inshallah. And it'll take some time before we get a grip on this. Mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. Right? It used to convey a possession, something possessed by something else. Relationship between two nouns, yeah? Two nouns, it is short. The whole construction is called Idafa. That is, the relationship is called Al-Idafa too. Right? And Idafa contains a mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. Idafa contains a mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. English uses of or apostrophe as. In English, we show possession by using of. Yeah, for such a relationship. For example, book of Bilal or Bilal's book. But in Arabic, we use two words which come in a special form of construction. Special form of construction, which is called mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, the possessed or possession. And inshallah, when we start doing the exercises and the lesson, inshallah, it will become more clear. When we get into the practical lessons and the exercises, inshallah, it will become clear, inshallah. But as of now, please have a look here. Kitabu Bilalin. Kitabu Bilalin. This is Kitab and this is Bilalin. Right, book of Bilal. Book of Bilal. Okay. Book of Bilal. Kitabu Bilalin. So what is Kitabu? We learnt in the lesson that any word should have, right? Should have Alif Lam or Tanween. Right? Should have either definite in lesson number two. Right? Alif Lam. Or Tanween, right? Or Tanween. Right? Alif Lam or Tanween, we learned in the lesson. But Mudaf is an exception. The word, the first word doesn't take Alif Lam. Remember this. The first word, Mudaf, doesn't take Alif Lam or Tanween anytime, right? It can take a single Dhamma, it can take a single Kasra, it can take a single Fatha, but never Tanween, never. That's how we identify that this word is a mudaf by it not taking alif lam and tanween. Why? Because if this word also takes alif lam and tanween, then it'll become confusing. We'll not be able to identify that these two words form a relationship between close relationship between each other. Right? The first word mudaf can take any case endings. Yeah, this is important. It can take one dhamma, one fatha, one kasra. Right? It can take any case endings as need be. It never takes Tanween. It never takes Tanween. Or the Alif Lam. Or the Alif Lam. It doesn't take either of those. Alif Lam or Tanween, it never takes. We've learned in the previous sessions that any word should have Alif Lam or Tanween except this here. Yeah, except this here. And there are several exceptions. But as of now, the Mudaf, it's called the Mudaf. It is Ma'rifa or Nakira. If you remember previous lesson, we have Ma'rifa and Nakira. Any word which has alif lam is called ma'rifa, that is definite. And any word which is nakira is called indefinite. Yeah, indefinite is called nakira. Right? For example, kitabun is indefinite, nakira. Right? And al-kitabu is ma'rifa, that is definite. That is definite. Okay? So the first word doesn't take tanween nor the while alif lam. While the second word can take anything. It can take Tanween. It can take Alif Lam. But it has to be only Kasra. It's only Majroor. It is only always majroor. Baytullahi. You cannot pronounce it as Baytullah or Baytullahu. No, that's wrong totally. The second word always has a kasra. That is the only condition. It can take tanween, it can take alif lam. It can have tanween or alif lam. For example, maktabul mudarrisi. So how do you translate this word? We translate the second word first. The teacher's table or the table of the teacher. Anything is fine, yeah? The teacher's table or the table of the teacher. Anything is fine. It can be nakira or ma'rifa. The second word can be nakira or ma'rifa, inshallah. So please try to remember, as of now, even if you're not able to understand a lot of it, the first word is called mudaf. The second word is called mudaf ilayhi. The second word is called mudaf ilayhi. Okay, inshallah. Examples. Examples, for example, maktabul mudarrisi. The table, maktab is the table. Notice this word doesn't have alif lam, doesn't have tanween. Maktab, that table of the teacher. Okay, of is understood. Okay, by looking at this construction itself, you get a sense of ownership in Arabic. You get a sense of ownership of something. Yeah, maktabul mudarrisi. Because of this kasra also. Yeah, because of looking at this kasra, you get a look at this. One second, please. Okay. By getting a sense, looking at this kasra, you get a sense of ownership that this something is belonging to someone. Yeah, something is belonging to someone. Yeah? For example, inna is also used. Inna maktabal mudarrisi. And we learn, inshallah, in book 2, lesson number 1, that whenever inna comes, you'll get a fatha. It'll become mansub because of inna. Inna allaha. It can never be inna allahu or inna allahi, inshallah. We learn in book 2, lesson number 1, inshallah. Inna comes for stress, verily, without doubt. Right? After the word mansub, it is always mansub. Mansub means accusative. Accusative. Yeah, accusative. Mansub is accusative. Inna maktabal mudarrisi. So you see, it can either be marfu, which is having a dhamma, having a fatha, right? Mansub, or having a kasra. It could have either. For example, a preposition come. Ala maktabil mudarrisi. So this could have anything, inshallah. Right? This could have anything. And the mudaf ilayhi could be ma'rifa or nakira. For example, at-talibi kitabu talib. The book, the student's book. The student's book. How do you translate it? The book, the student's book. Do you translate the second word and then the first word? The student's book. How do you translate it? The student's book. Right? The student's book. And similarly, for the second, kitabu talibin, which is nakira, it has tanween. Notice here, we have tanween, inshallah. We have tanween here. Kitabu talibin, a student's book. Instead of the student's book, it is a student's book, inshallah. Okay? A student's book. And there are several times we cannot have these things. Okay, please notice, we cannot have these things. For example, kitabun bilalin. Right? Why this is wrong? Because this has a tanween. It cannot have a tanween. Mudaf cannot have a tanween. This is wrong, inshallah. Al kitabu bilalin. This is also wrong. Mudaf cannot have al. Wrong. Kitabu bilalun. Wrong. Why? The second word, mudaf ilayhi, cannot be marfu. It cannot have dhamma. It cannot have dhamma. Kitabu bilalan. It cannot have fatha. It cannot have fatha. The only correct form is this one. The first word should be mudaf. The second word is the mudaf ilayhi. No alif lam, no tanween, and no dhamma and fatha. Only kasra, which is kasra here. Inshallah, right? Inshallah. We'll learn more, inshallah, in future. But as of now, notice, kitabu man is also used. Kitabu man. Kitabun man. This is also mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. But man is a fixed type of word. Yeah, fixed type of word. So man doesn't get a kasra. We'll learn in the future, inshallah. But this is called mabni. Mabni words are those which do not have other clothes. They're like fixed. Right? They won't change whatever comes before it or after it, whatever. Man is similar to that. It's called mabni. Right? It's called mabni. So what is kalamu man? Whose pen is this? Ibn man, whose son is this, inshallah? Whose son is this? And we could have multiple mudaf and mudaf ilayhis. Huh? So what is this? Masjidu Rasuli Allahi. So how will you translate it? Allah's messenger's masjid. The last word first. Or the mosque of the Prophet of Allah. Right? That there could be two sets, three sets, four sets, five sets. You could have mudaf mudaf. So the middle word is a mudaf ilayhi for this word. Right? And it acts as a mudaf for this word. So it has a double role. This word has a double role. This word has a double role. It plays two roles. Yeah, two roles. This word has a double role. Inshallah, we'll understand this, inshallah, when we start doing the lesson. For example, Nasrullahi, Allah's help. See, Nasr is aja Nasrullah. This is mudaf. This is mudaf ilayhi. The first word doesn't have alimam, that doesn't have tanween. And the second word doesn't have fatha dhamma. Right? It has only kasra. Bi rabbin nas. Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. Because of B, this word became kasra. Right? And this is mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Allahu nuru samawati. See? This is mudaf. No alif lam, no tanmeen. And this is mudaf ilayhi. Inshallah. Rasulullahi. Allah's messenger. Daru salami. House of peace. Or, yeah, house, home of safety. Wa'adallahi. Allah's messenger. Allah's messenger. Inshallah. Allah's promise. Wa'adallahi, Allah's promise, inshallah. We'll begin the lesson 5, inshallah, where we will learn slowly, slowly. It will take time to register all these things, yeah. It'll take time for us to totally grasp mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. But that the intro, what I wanted to give, is to give you an overview of what mudaf, mudaf ilayhi is. Even if you understand 20 to 30%, inshallah, there's no issues, inshallah, because we've not started the lesson yet. Inshallah. Once we finish lesson 5, then it'll keep coming in lesson 6, 7, 8, and it'll keep coming till our books end. Inshallah. And it'll keep coming in the Quran also, because mudaf and mudaf ilayhi is the most common thing in the language. Yeah, it's one of the most common things in the language. Like the prepositions we learned in the 4th lesson, right? These are also the most common things which will keep coming in the language, inshallah ta'ala. So let's start reading. Sa'idun. Sa'idun says, a kitabu. We understood that Sa'idun, this is a masculine name. If you remember last time, we've learned that any masculine name is ma'rifa. It is definite because you know his name, right? Even though it has a tanween, right? So we learned in the previous lesson that masculine names have tanween, 90%, right? That's why we will read it as Sa'idun. Sa'idun. We will read it as Sa'idun. Sa'idun. This will come as Sa'idun. Right? We will read it as Sa'idun. Right? Which is Sa'id. Right? Sa'idun. Sa'id. It's a masculine name and it is proper noun. So it is what it is? Definite. Okay? It is Ma'rifa. What is definite? What we learned before is Ma'rifa. Next, a kitab. What is this a? This is called Hamzatul Istifham, which we learned before. Yeah, I keep repeating this because to register, inshallah, so that we can remember it properly. A is for used for questioning. And another word which is used for questioning, which we learned is, can anyone tell me what is used for questioning? And anyone? If you remember, we use something else also for questioning. Right? And if anyone remembers, what do we use for questioning? We use a, right? Is or did, whatever translation is. We use a. And the other word is, we use is hal. Hal. Okay? And both have the same meaning. We can either use hal or we can either use a. Right? These are used like a question mark. Because remember that the previous Arabic language, the classical Arabic language, did not have punctuation. Did not have punctuation. So they had to have something to identify whether it's a question or not. And istifham, they used to use the word specifically used for questioning. Mata, man, yeah, when, where, who. These are specifically used for questioning. And these are and hal are used for yes or no questions. We could have yes or no questions, yeah? yes and no. There could be two types of questions. Yeah, there could be several questions, like, but this is like yes or no. Is this true or not? Yeah, and we could reply with naam or la. We could reply with yes or no, inshallah. So A is called Hamzatul Istifham. What is A called? Hamzatul Istifham. And Kitabu Muhammadin. This is our first encounter with a Mudaf and Mudaf Ilayhi. Notice this is the Kitab, which is the possessed. And the possessed thing is called, what is it called? Hal. Yes, Hal. Jazakallah khair. The possessed thing is called Kitabu. This is called Mudaf. This is called Mudaf. Yeah. This is called Mudaf. This is called Mudaf. Please. And this will not have alif lam, no alif lam, no tanween, right? No alif lam, no tanween. That is the only two conditions here for this kitabu. And look at the Muhammadin. Oh, why do we have Muhammadin here? Because this is mudaf ilayhi, the owner of the book. So how will you translate kitabu Muhammadin as Muhammad's book or Book of Muhammad? Both are fine, right? In English, we use both of these things. Kitabu Muhammadin hada. So we learned in the previous lesson that hada should come in the big, in the starting, right? But this is also fine. This is also fine to bring it in the ending when it's a mudaf and mudaf ilay. When you have a mudaf and mudaf ilayhi here, we can bring it in the end also, right? Bringing in the end is also fine. So that, but to translate that, is this the book of Muhammad or is Muhammad's book, is this, O Yasir. Now notice one more rule here. Whenever we have a Ya coming, O Yasir, yeah, the Tanween drops. The actual name is Yasirun. Yasirun. Right? When we add a Ya, we have to call him Yasiru. Ya Yasiru. Similarly, if you want to call Muhammadun, how will you do that? Ya. How will you do that? Ya. Muhammadu. Okay. Ya Muhammadu. We cannot call him Ya Muhammadun. That's wrong. Because this is called Harfun Nida. Inshallah, we learn vocative particle. Inshallah, anything after that, you have to drop the tanween. Okay, let's. So, what is the first sentence translation? Is this Muhammad's book, O Yasir? What is it? Is this Muhammad's book, O Yasir? So, Yasirun, see, it has a tanween because male names have tanween. Yasirun says, La, no, Hada, this book is Kitabu Hamidin. No, this book is Hada. This book is Kitabu Hamidin. This book is Hamid's book. How do you know to Hamid's book? Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Right? Look at the mudaf again. No alif lam, no tanween. And Hamidin has kasra. It could be one kasra or two kasras, yeah? Because masculine names have tanween. That's why it's kitabu Hamidin. Right? This is Hamid's book. That's it. Is this the book of Muhammad? No, this is Hamid's book. Let's go below. Sa'id then continues to say, Aina kitabu Muhammadin. Okay, fine. This is Hamid's book. Where is Muhammad's book? Aina kitabu Muhammadin. Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Right? Mudaf doesn't have alif lam, doesn't have tanween. Mudaf ilayhi doesn't have dhamma and fatha. It has only kasra. Aina is where. Right? Aina is where. So Muhammad says, where is Muhammad's book then? It's fine that, okay, fine. Hamid's book is here. Where is Muhammad's book? Yasirun says, Huwa tahtal maktabi hunaka. It is below the table there. What is this tahta? Tahta is an adverb of place. It's called zarf. What is it called? Zarfun. It's called adverb. There are two types of adverbs, by the way. Adverb of time, which tell us time. And zarfu makan, this is. What is called? Zarfu makan, adverb of place. Right, of place. Zalfu makan, naam. Makan and zaman. This is adverb of place. It tells you a place. Fauqa, tahta, whatever. Yeah, tahta is below. And remember always, any word after the zarf, after the pronoun, after an adverb, becomes mudaf ilayhi. Right? Why is this tahta al-maktabi? Because any word after the adverb is also a mudaf ilayhi, by the way. Huwa tahta al-maktabi. Okay? Why is it? Because if you try to translate literally, right, below of the table, right, or tables below, okay, but we don't speak like that in Arabic, tables below, or right, but in Arabic, this is fine. This is also a pattern of mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, inshallah ta'ala, mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, right, so tahta is below. And this is mudaf ilayhi. So anytime, but we don't say tahta as mudaf. No. This is not okay. We say tahta as zarf and zarf plus mudaf ilayhi. Zarf plus mudaf ilayhi. Zarf plus mudaf ilayhi. Okay. Inshallah. Hunaka. What is hunaka? There. Hunaka is also a type of zarf. Right? It is also a type of zarf. Hunaka. But it generally doesn't take a mudaf ilayhi. No word comes after it. Hunaka is just there. Hunaka. Huna means here. Hunaka means there. Inshallah, we'll learn more in the exercise. Saeed says, Aina daftaru ammarin. What is daftar? Notebook. Kurrasa is also said. Daftar is also another word. Where is the notebook of Ammar? Of Ammar's notebook. Right? See, mudaf ilayhi, the owner, kasra, and mudaf, no alif lam, no tanween. Where is the notebook of Ammar? It is on the table of the teacher. Look now. Huwa mubtada. Like we learned mubtada, right? Mubtada, khabar, the subject, mubtada. Ala is the preposition. We learned in the fourth lesson that any word which comes after ala should get a kasra. So, didn't we get a kasra here? Yes, but only one kasra. Why? Because mudaf doesn't take tanween. It should, if this wasn't there, ala maktabin, on a table, would be fine. But because this became mudaf, only one kasra. So because of this, this became ala maktabi, and then we'll join it to this, ala maktabin mudarrisi, on the teacher's table, or on the table of the teacher. Look at the mudaf ilayhi. It has alif lam, right? Because mudaf ilayhi can take alif lam and it has a kasra. So the teacher is the owner of the table. Yeah. So it is on the table of the teacher. Right? Inshallah. Saeed says, Qalamu man hada ya Ali. So we just learned that Qalamu man means whose pen is this? Whose pen? Qalamu man is also a type of a mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, but man doesn't show its feelings. Right, so there are several types of people, right? According to the MBIT, there are 16 types of personalities in the world. Right? Some of them are more logical, some of them are more emotional, right? Some of them are introverts, some of them are extroverts, right? Some of them use their sensing, that is, they take in information through their five senses. Some of them use intuitions. They don't take the information from the five senses. They take information through the sixth sense. Like they look at the bigger picture. They're not detail oriented. Some of them use thinking trait more. Some of them use feelings more. And the last is some of them are judging personalities. That is, they want everything in order, right? While some of them are perceptive, that is, they don't plan so much for the future. So there are 16 types of personalities according to MBIT types of personalities. Yeah, if you want to test your personality, you should try out 16personalities.com. Yeah. So in that, we understand that everyone has different ways of expressing emotions. Some of them are, for them, emotions they can easily express. For them, it's very, for some of us, it's very difficult to express something, right? So that is because of a judging and perceptive behaviors or feeling or thinking traits. Yeah, everyone has all these eight traits, but some of them are more than the others. We all have emotions, but some of us are more emotional. Yeah, all of us have logic, but some of us are more logical and they think everything in logic, right? So this is how. Similarly, man doesn't express anything. Okay, it is mabni, fixed, no emotions at all, no fatha, dhamma, kasra. It is always like this. But we should look with it and try to find out its emotion. So it is actually majroor, but it doesn't show that it is majroor. We'll learn more about this in the future. Mabni words. These are called mabni, which are not actually majroor, but in the place of majroor. Yeah, inshallah. Fi mahalli jar, it's called. Inshallah, we'll learn in the future, inshallah. But remember, this is also mudaf and mudaf ilay. For example, if man wasn't there, Sa'id was there in place of man. So what will it be? Qalamu Sa'idin. Right? So man took the place of Sa'id. So something like that, yeah, inshallah. Qalamu man, as of now, if you want to understand in a basic way, Qalamu man means whose pen? Is this O Ali? Whose pen is this O Ali? So Ali says, Hada Qalamul Mudarrisi. This is the teacher's pen. Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. This is the teacher's pen. Right? Teacher's pen. This is the teacher, this is the pen. Right? Teacher's pen. Hada Qalamul Mudarrisi. This is the teacher's pen. Right? Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Mudaf ilayhi has a kasra. Sa'id says, Aina Haqibatul Mudarrisi. Where is the bag of the teacher? Look, this is the bag, right? Haqiba is the bag. Okay? Haqiba is the bag. Haqiba is the bag. Haqiba is the bag. Aina haqibatul mudarrisi? Where is the teacher, bag of the teacher? Hiya. Why is it here now? Instead of huwa, it huwa and hiya could also mean hit it, right? So this is ta. Because of this ta, it became hiya. Hiya tahtal maktabi. It is below the table. Female, yes, it is female, yeah. Yeah, it is. It's not she is below the table. Although hiya could mean she. But because everything is male or female in Arabic language, it is hiya tahtal maktabi. It is below the table. Inshallah, this was the lesson. Inshallah. Now we'll go into the exercises. Tamareen, exercises. Because exercises help us in understanding everything in a very good way, inshallah. Answer the following questions. Ajibanil aslatil ati. Answer the. Aina kitabu Muhammadin? Where is Muhammad's book? See how am I translating it? Where is Muhammad's book? Or where is the book of Muhammad? Right? Aina is where. Where is the book of Muhammad? So where is it? Book of Muhammad? Huwa tahta al maktabi hunaka. It is under the table there. Under the table. Tahta is under. It is under the table there. Aina kitabu Ammarin? Where is the book of Ammar? So where is Ammar's book? Huwa ala maktabil mudarrisi. It is on the teacher's table. Huwa ala maktabil mudarrisi. It is on the teacher's table. It is on the teacher's table. Aina haqibatul mudarrisi? Where is the teacher's bag? Can anyone answer? Where is the teacher's bag? Where is the teacher's bag? Where is the teacher's bag? From the lesson. Aina haqibatul mudarrisi? Anyone? It's right in front of us. Okay, jazakallahu khair. Hiya tahtal maktabi. Why? Hiya. Why is it hiya? Because it is female, yeah, inshallah. She, naam, barakallahu feekum. Hiya tahtal maktabi, right? It is below the table. Ends with ta, okay? Ends with ta, the round ta. It's called round ta, inshallah. Next, let's look the adif al kalimat al ula ila thaniya. Rewrite the two words in each of the following words, making so that the second word is in the possessive form. So we have two words here. We will try to make mudaf and mudaf ilayhi. For example, kitabu kitabun, a book, Muhammadun, Muhammad. So we have to make kitabu Muhammadin, Muhammad's book. This is the mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. So what did we do? We chopped off the tanween. And we chopped off the Dhamma here and made it Kasra. That's it. Kitabu Muhammadin. Naam. Kitabu Muhammadin. So what's the next one? Qalamu Hamidin. Let's write Qalamu Hamidin. Let's write one or two. Qalamu Hamidin. Qalamu. Right? We never have Tanween for this word. No Qalamun. It's always Qalamu. Qalamu Hamidin. And Akasra. Hamid's pen. In translations, Hamid's pen. Qalamu Hamidin. Baitun Abbasun. We have to say Abbas house. Baitu Abbasin. Right? Baitu Abbasin. Abbasin. House of Abbas. Ghurfatu. Ghurfatun Aliyun. So this will be Ghurfatu Aliyin. Ali's room. Translation is Ali's room. Ghurfa is room. Yeah, Ghurfatu Aliyin. Ghurfatu Aliyin. Ghurfatu Aliyin. This is Tanween, okay? It's not showing properly. Daftarun Sa'idun. Notebook of Sa'id. Daftaru Sa'idin. Daftaru. In Urdu, daftar is office, but in Arabic, it means notebook. Daftaru Sa'idin. Mindilun Yasirun. Mindil is handkerchief. We learned before, right? Mindil is handkerchief. So we have to say similarly, rest all that. Mindilun Yasirun. Mindilu Yasirin. So what we do is we chop this off and make this into kasra. Mindilu Yasirin. Kamisu Ammarin. Right? Kamisu Ammarin. Ammar's shirt. Handkerchief of Yasir. Sariru Khalidin. Bed of Khalid. Sarir is bed. Right? Sariru Khalidin. Right? This is how you make for this. And these words are also Ma'rifa, by the way. Why are they Ma'rifa? Because these names are definite. So these should also become definite, right? This should also become definite. Similarly, next here, these are proper nouns. Now we have common. Maktabun al-mudarrisu. Now I have to say the teacher's table. Maktab is the table, right? The teacher's table. So how will I say? Maktabul mudarrisi. I'll chop this tanween out and this kasra. It'll make dhamma to kasra. Next one, please. Miftahul bayti. Yes. The keys of the house. The keys, miftahul. Miftah is the key, right? Al bayti. Miftahul bayti. The keys of the house. We learned, right? And this is one dhamma. Tajir dukan. Shop and tajir. Dukanu tajiri. Yeah? Dukanu at-tajiri. The shop of the trader. Inshallah. Similarly, all are in a similar fashion. Dukanu tajiri. Baitul Muhandisi, right? Baitul Muhandisi. Baitun and Al Muhandisu. So how will you do? Baitul Muhandisi, the engineer's house, or the house of the engineer. Ismu, Ismun, and Al Waladu. So this will be Ismul Waladi, the name of the child, of the boy. Ismul Waladi. Kitabun Allahu. So you have to say Allah's book. Kitabullahi, right? Allahi, Kitabullahi. Kitabullahi. Oh, this is not coming. Anyways, okay. Bintun at-tabibu. Girl, doctor. So I have to say doctor's girl or doctor's daughter. Bint is also daughter, by the way. Or the girl. Bintu at-tabibi. The doctor's daughter. Miftahun as-sayyaratu. Miftahu as-sayyarati. Miftahu sayyarati, the key of the car or the car's key. Miftahu sayyarati. Miftahu sayyarati. Right? Miftahu sayyarati. Inshallah. Right? Miftahu sayyarati. Miftahu sayyarati. Okay, I hope this is easy now, inshallah. This exercise you understood in a good way. Jayyidan, inshallah. What we did here? Qalamu Hamidin Baitu. The first word should never have Tanween. So, Daftaru, Mindilu, Qamisu, Sariru, Qalamu, Kitabu.
And the second word should also have always have kasra. Hamidin, similarly al-bayti, at-tajiri. This cannot have tanween because this has alif lam, right? We learned in the previous lesson. Alif lam. Naam. So only what you have is only kasra, right? This first word doesn't have alif lam or tanween. The second word always has a kasra. Always has a kasra. Okay, inshallah ta'ala. Always has a kasra. Baytul muhandisi. Ismul waladi. Similar way, inshallah. Let's do the next exercise, inshallah. Next exercise is read and write each of the following phrases vocalizing the last letter of the both word of both the words. So we have to vocalize the last ma dabt. Dabt is the last letter of both the words. Both the words, inshallah. So let's read this. What is this words? These two words, please. The ending should be clear, okay? What's these two words? Babun al madrasatun. Al-Madrasatu. So what should it be now? How do you read this now? Babul Madrasati. See? Now, when you see two words like this, you should get a doubt. Ah, this is Mudaf and Mudaf Ilayhi. Right? This is Mudaf and Mudaf Ilayhi. So this should be only one Dhamma and this should get a Kasra. And what does it translate to? The school's door. Right? Or the door of the school. Inshallah. Next one. Himarur Rajuli. Right? This is again one Dhamma and a Kasra. Himarur Rajuli. Man's donkey. The man's donkey. The man's donkey. Himarur Rajuli. Next one. Next one, please. Can anyone translate? Baitu Hamidin. Okay? Here we didn't have Tanween because of this Alif Lam. But whenever you see a masculine name, it always has tanween. So this is baytu and this should get hamidin. Baytu hamidin. Hamid's house. Hamid's house. Right? Baytu hamidin. Hamid's house. Next one is sayyaratul mudiri. Car. What is sayyara? This is car. And al-mudiri? Principal, right? Principal. Principal of the college or school, whatever. Sayyadatul Mudiri, the principal's car. That's how we translate, inshallah. The principal's car. Next one, Mindilu Ammarin. Right? The handkerchief of Ammar. Mindilu. Only one Dhamma. Ammarin. Right? Next one, please. Can anyone read the endings? This one. Mindulu Ammarin. The next one after that. This one. I wrote. Oh, you've written. Okay. Ismut Talibi. Yes. Ismut Talibi. Now, Ismut Talibi. The name of the student. Okay. Ismut Talibi. The student's name. This is Marifa. How do you know it's Marifa? Because of this Alif Lam. Ismu Talibi. Baytullahi. Allah's house. See? If anyone is reading Baytun Allahi, wrong. Baytun Allaha, wrong. Baytun Allahu, wrong. It's Baytullahi. Always. Inshallah. This one doesn't take Alif Lam, no Tanween. And this one doesn't take Fatha, no Dhamma. Only Kasra. One kasra or two kasra, depending on whether it's definite or indefinite. Next one, please. This one is a little tricky. This whole thing. Fi kitabullahi. No, 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 no. Again, please look into it. Lesson 4, we learned something. Yeah, because of fi. because of fi, the mudaf gets one kasra. Fi, yes, it becomes genitive, majroor, genitive case. Fi kitabillahi. This is already genitive because lafzul jalala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the word Allah, lafzul jalala, is always, I mean, is already mudaf ilayhi. So what is this? Fi kitabillahi. Now, someone might ask you, why is this kasra here? You should say, because of fi. Why is this kasra here? Because of fi. Right? Because of this fi. Now, someone will ask, why is this kasra on the lafzul jalala? Because it is the mudaf ilayhi. There are two separate reasons. Yeah, this is one reason and this is another reason. This is because this is mudaf ilayhi. This is because of the harfu jar. Because of this reason. Okay, the two separate reasons totally. This is mudaf ilayhi, inshallah. Barakallahu fi. Naam, fi kitabillahi, in the house of Allah. How do you translate it? In the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min baytil mudarrisi, from the teacher's house. Min baytil mudarrisi. Min, because of min, this became kasra. And because this is mudaf ilayhi. Right, mudaf ilayhi. Min baytil, from the teacher's house. Inshallah. Last one, please. Someone again. Last one. We have a preposition. Ala maktabil mudiri. That's right. Alhamdulillah. Because of ala, this became a kasra. And because al mudiri is mudaf ilayhi, this became. The translator is on the principal's table. On the principal's table. On the principal's table. On the principal's table. Okay. Inshallah. So, please. Try to practice this, inshallah. It will take time, but once you get a grip of it, it will become easier, inshallah. Ta'ala. Inshallah ta'ala. Right? Okay. We have 20 sentences. We'll do 10 sentences today, and then the rest we'll do tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala. We'll do 10 sentences, just reading a practice sentence, inshallah ta'ala. Right? And then we'll continue from tomorrow. The rest of the exercise, inshallah. I want to give a gap because the information should be digested, inshallah. Right? If I finish the whole lesson today, it'll become too much heavy. Right? The constructions and stuff. So we need a gap, inshallah. So we'll read the first 10 sentences and then please try to revise by tomorrow, inshallah, so that it will not be an information overload. The iqra, read. Aina baytul mudarrisi. Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Where is the teacher's house? Huwa ba'idun. It is far. Huwa ba'idun. It is far. Where is the teacher's house? It is far. Right? So I hope you're understanding mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, inshallah. Where is the teacher's house? It is far. Al-Qur'anu kitabullahi. The Qur'an is Allah's book. How am I translating this? Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Yeah? The Qur'an, Al-Qur'anu, because of Alif Lam, we don't have Tanween, right? Because Alif Lam and Tanween cannot come together. Al-Qur'anu Kitabullahi, the Qur'an is the book of Allah. Al-Ka'batu, the Ka'ba, Baytullahi, is Allah's house. Allah's house, Baytullahi. Mudaf and Mudaf. Mudaf doesn't take Tanween, no Alif Lam. And Mudaf ilayhi always is genitive, Majroor. Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Rasulullahi. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. Rasulullahi. You see, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Similarly, if you notice, this is the mubtada, this is the subject, and this is the predicate. Baytu is the predicate, and Allahi is the mudaf ilayhi. Inshallah. Right? Subject predicate is also happening in the sentence. Yeah. Subject and predicate. Next, kharaja. Oh, verb. There's a verb here. We learnt in fourth lesson, if you remember. Verbs. Verbs. Kharaja. Can anyone tell me what does kharaja mean? Went. Yeah, he went. Right? Kharaja is he went. Okay? Kharajat is she went. Kharaja is he went, inshallah. Kharaja is he went. So, where any time a verb comes in a sentence, you should try to search for a fa'il. If you remember, we learned last time, right? You should try to search for a fa'il. So where is the fa'il of the ayn al-fa'il? Where is the fa'il of this sentence? Is it hidden or is it present in the sentence? The fa'il, you remember fa'il? The doer of the action. Fa'il is the one who is the doer of the action. It's hidden. Careful. Is it hidden really? Ask the question. Who came out? Who came out? Read the whole sentence, please. No. Mudir, where's Mudir? No, Mudir is not the fa'il. No, Mudir is not the actor. The teacher. Yes, the teacher. It's next to it. This is the doer. Okay. So, it can be hidden if this is not there. Kharaja min ghulfa. He came out from the principal's room. But now, it is there. Who came out? The teacher came out. And remember, we learned the file should always have a dhamma, marfu. The file is always marfu with a dhamma. Right? Kharajal mudarrisu. Who came out? The teacher came out. So, how do we translate it? The teacher came out. We don't translate it as the teacher, he came out. Right? If this wasn't there, we'll translate this as he came out, right? It is mudarrisu. The teacher came out. It's not a teacher, the teacher. It is mudarrisu, right? It is mudarrisu, by the way. It's mudarrasu. Oh, you're getting confused between this. Oh, in Arabic font, if the tajdeed, if the sign is below the tajdeed, it is kasra. Okay. So in Arabic font, in Indian font, right? In Indian font, we write kasra here anytime. Okay, inshallah. Right? But in Arabic, when we have a tajdeed, if this is fatha and this is kasra, this is not kasra. Okay? It is mudarris. It is mudarris. So we look at the sign. If it's below the tajdeed, it is kasra. If it's above the tajdeed, it is fatha. Inshallah. Okay? Inshallah. See, like here, Muhammad. Naam, inshallah. Right? This is a script problem, right? In India, Pakistan, we don't have this script. But Muhammad, this is above the tajdeed. Now, this is below the tajdeed. Right? Below the tajdeed, it is kasra. Mudarris. Naam, inshallah. And this is written in the font of Arabic Hijaz style, right? So, inshallah. Kharajal mudarrisu, the teacher came out from the principal's room. So, because of from, this became a kasra, right? And because genitive, yeah. And because this is a mudaf ilayhi, this became a kasra, genitive again. Yeah, majroor. Next one. Hada baytu hamidin. This is Hamid's house. Wadalika baytu khalidin. And that is Khalid's house. Simple. Hada baytu hamidin. Wadalika baytu khalidin. Mudaf, mudafile, mudaf, mudafile. This is mudaf. This is mudafile. This is mudaf. This is mudafile. Inshallah. Ibnu ammarin talibun. The son of Ammar is a student. Wabnu. See? This is a Hamzatul Wasl. Inshallah, we'll learn more in the next class, tomorrow's class. This is a joining Wasl, I mean Hamza. And when anything comes before it, we delete it. We read as Wabunu. Inshallah, we'll learn this in the future, inshallah. Wabunu Yasirin, but I referenced it many times. It's called Hamzatul Wasl, joining Hamza. Wabunu Yasirin Tajirun. Yasir's son is a trader. Yasir's son is a trader. Ibnu. Right, when there's nothing before it, we are reading it as ibn, but if there's something after joining, we read it as wabnu, right? Minabni, ilabni, right? Something like that. Ibnu Ammarin Talibun, son of Ammar is a student, and Yasir's son is a tajir. Eighth point, Baitul Mudarrisi Ba'idun, the teacher's house is far. وَبَيْتُ التَّاجِرِ قَرِيبٌ and the trader's house is near. Right? Every time you notice مُضَاف مُضَاف إِلَيْهِ مُضَاف مُضَاف إِلَيْهِ. Right? هَذَا مِفْتَاحُ السَّيَّارَةِ This is the car's key. أَيْنَ مِفْتَاحُ الْبَيْتِ Where's the house keys? I want the house keys, not the car keys. أَيْنَ مِفْتَاحُ الْبَيْتِ Where is the house keys? هَذَا مِفْتَاحُ السَّيَّارَةِ This is the car keys. Where is the house keys? Last sentence for today. مَنْ أَنْتَ يَا وَلَدُ Who are you, O boy? أَنَا بْنُ عَبَّاسِ I am the son of Abbas. أَنَا بْنُ عَبَّاسِ Right? Ibn. So, there was something before this. Ibn, right? So, we joined it and read it as أَنَا بْنُ عَبَّاسِ Because this Hamza is a Hamzatul Wasl. There are two types of Hamzas. One is a Wasl which is written like this. And another is Qata which has a small Hamza written. Right? Wasl should always be joined if there is something before it. Qata should always be pronounced. Like Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka. So even if Waw is coming, we won't join it like Waiyaka. Right? We will have to stop and pronounce the Hamza. Wa Iyaka. Similarly here, this is Hamdatul Wasl. So we won't say that Huwa Ibnu Khalidin. No. We will drop this Hamzatul Wasl totally. And read it as Huwa Ibnu Khalidin. Ana Ibnu Abbasin. Right? I am the son of Abbas, inshallah. That's it for today, inshallah. We'll continue from the 11th lesson, sentence tomorrow, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Inshallah. If there are any questions, we'll take them, inshallah. Ta'ala. Any more? Inshallah. Please try to keep coming, inshallah. Have a dawam in coming like this. Try to attend the classes, inshallah. Slowly, slowly, slowly. You may not understand 100% now. But our goal is 50 to 60% and that gets developed, inshallah, inshallah. Right? Nobody can understand anything 100%. Right? For everything has depths which we won't understand now. But in future, we might. So there are two types of mindsets, right? There's one fixed mindset and there's a growth mindset. The fixed mindset is the mindset which says that, oh, this is difficult. I cannot learn. I cannot learn driving. I cannot learn to swim and so on. Right? They are fixed. So their whole life, they are fixed. Right? But a growth mindset is the one which has the mindset that anything can be learned in this world. Nothing is difficult, inshallah. It just requires patience, determination and practice. Right? It just requires patience, a lot of patience, yeah, and a lot of grit. It's called grit, G-R-I-T. Right? And there was a survey done that who are the most successful people after 5 years. So they started here, day one and they observed them for 5 years. And they realized that the only person who was successful was the one who had grit, who had determination. Right? Not the clever one, not the one with the highest IQ, not the one who has a lot of money. No, the only person who succeeded was the one who had determination, inshallah. So we should have sabr and determination. Inna allaha ma'as sabirin. Barakallahu feekum. Jazakallahu khair. Nothing, the language cannot be learned in one day. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruk wa atubu ilaik. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون